Sexual reproduction in fungi. Fungi are eukaryotic heterotrophs and they reproduce by both asexual and sexual methods. In the last class, we discussed about the asexual reproduction methods of fungi, which include fission, budding, fragmentation, and spore formation. Today, we will discuss about sexual reproduction methods in fungi. Fungi reproduce sexually by 5 different methods, which include gametic copulation, gametangial copulation, gametangial copulation, somatic copulation, and spermatization. Both by asexual and asexual methods, the spores are produced by fungi. The function of both sexual and asexual spores is the dissemination of fungus. The spores, when they fall on suitable media and the environmental conditions are favorable, they will germinate and give rise to new fungus. In the case of sexual reproduction, we can consider the fungus as 2 different groups, that is homothallic fungus and the heterothallic fungus. Homothallic fungus means both the sex cells that is required for mating is present in the same fungus, means the fungus are able to mate with themselves. While in the heterothallic fungus, opposite sex cells are in different individuals. Fungal spores. Asexual spores of fungus include sporangiospores, conidiospores or conidia, Oidia, which is otherwise known as arthrospores or thallospores, chlamydospores, and blastospores. Sexual spores include ascospores, basidiospores, zygospores, and oospores. The process of sexual reproduction in fungus. When we discussed about asexual reproduction in the last class, we studied that in asexual reproduction, there is no fusion of sex organelles or sex cells from 2 different organisms. In the case of sexual reproduction, the thing is different. Here there is fusion of compatible nuclei of 2 parental cells. In fungus, sexual reproduction follows the following steps like plasmogamy, karyogamy, followed by meiosis. Plasmogamy is the fusion of protoplast. 2 parental cells fuse with each other and their protoplasm is also fused, and this process is called plasmogamy. Plasmogamy is followed by karyogamy. In karyogamy, there is fusion of haploid nuclei of 2 mating types. Now the number of chromosome becomes 2N. So the zygote, which is formed by the fusion of 2 parental cells, will be having 2N number of chromosomes. So the zygote will undergo meiosis to reduce the diploid chromosome into a haploid number. In the case of meiosis, there are 2 cellular divisions, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. As a result of these cellular divisions, 4 haploid nuclei will be produced. This is different from other eukaryotic organisms. In other eukaryotic organisms, meiosis is taking place prior to plasmogamy and karyogamy, because in them, their chromosome number is diploid, so before the formation of the sex cell, the number has to be reduced to haploid or half the number of chromosomes. Coming to sex organelles of fungi. Sexually different fungal hyphae are termed as plus and minus strain. Or the opposite mating types of fungus are called plus and minus strains. Sex organs are not differentiated or well defined in all fungi. However, if sex organelles are present, they are called gametangia. Gametangia may differentiate into special sex cells called gametes, or they will be simply containing one or more gamete nuclei within a single structure. Male gametangium is called antheridium, and the female gametangium is called oogonium. Sexual reproduction methods of fungus includes gametic copulation, gamete-gametangial copulation, gametangial copulation, somatic copulation, and spermatization. Coming to the first method of sexual reproduction, that is gametic copulation. In the case of gametic copulation, both the male and female gametangium produce well-defined sex cells called the male and female gametes. So, in gametic copulation, there is fusion of well-differentiated uninucleate sex cells or gametes formed in the gametangia to form spores. Both the gametes or one of the gametes will be motile. If the male and female gametes are morphologically similar, they are called isogametes and their fusion is called isogamy. If the male and female gametes are morphologically different, they are called heterogametes or anisogametes and their fusion is called heterogamy or anisogamy. Coming to the second method, which is called gametangial copulation. In this case, either the male or female will be producing well-differentiated sex cells called gametes and the other will be having the gametangium instead of well-defined sex cells. In this process, two gametangia come into contact, but there is no fusion between the cells. In most of the cases, the female gametangium will be getting differentiated into well-defined gametes. So the female gametangium will be a large ball-like structure which will be containing many differentiated female gametes. And the male gametangium will not be getting differentiated into special gametic cells. Instead, they will be containing a number of nuclei in it. So, the female gametangium will come in contact with the male gametangium. So, the male nucleus from the male gametangium will migrate through a fertilization tube or pore into the female gametangium to form the spore. Coming to the third method, that is gametangial copulation. In the case of gametangial copulation, there is no differentiation of gametangia into gametes. So here two gametangia fuse and give rise to a zygote which will develop into a rusting spore. Fourth method, that is somatic copulation. In the case of somatic copulation, the sexual fusion of undifferentiated somatic or vegetative cells will take place and it will produce the sexual spores. The fungal hyphae is not differentiated into special gametangial structures. Coming to the last sexual reproduction method, that is spermatization. In the case of spermatization, there is a special male structure which is called spermatium. So here the union of the special male structure spermatium is taking place with the female receptive structure. During plasmogamy, there is no fusion of spermatia and the female receptive structure. Instead of that, the spermatia will empty its contents into the receptive female hyphae. So by these different sexual methods, different sexual spores will be produced. The common sexual spores found in fungi include ascospores, basidiospores, zygospores and oospores. Ascospores are formed within sac-like structures which is called ascus. In each ascus, 8 single-celled ascospores can be seen. In ascospore formation, the female structure included is called ascogonium. So the antheridium and the ascogonium of two mating types fused to form the ascogenous hyphae. Ascogenous hyphae is the hyphae from which the ascus is to be formed. Ascogenous hyphae formation is followed by crocea formation. In the diagram, we can see the crocea formation. A crocea is an anatomical feature of many fungi in the phylum Ascomycota that forms at the base of asce and looks like a hook-topped shepherd's crook. Crocea helps to maintain the dikaryotic state of both the ascus itself and of the side branch that will continue propagation of the ascogenous hyphae. In the diagram, we can see the crocea formation. During the crocea formation, the tip of the ascogenous hyphae curl over. And one of the haploid nucleus migrates into the curved tip, while the other compatible haploid nucleus remains in the penultimate space below the hook. Then each nucleus divides or undergoes mitosis, resulting in the formation of a pair of compatible nuclei, that is a dikaryote. Of the two sister nuclei remain, one in the basal cell and other in the crocea. The ascus usually forms itself as a radiating spur branch at the top of the hook from the penultimate or the second last cell. The tip of the crocea then fuses with the penultimate cell and walls itself off from the ascus by the formation of a septum. The nucleus from the crocea migrates into the penultimate cell where the other nucleus remains, thus maintaining the dikaryotic state of ascogenous hyphae. Below the base of the ascus, these nuclei migrate together into a growing side branch which is capable of repeating the ascus crocea formation process indefinitely. At the same time, within the ascus, the two nuclei fuse to form the diploid zygote. The diploid zygote divides immediately after the fusion by meiosis. And as we already mentioned in the sexual reproduction procedure, after meiosis, 4 haploid cells will be produced. But in the case of ascospore formation, this meiosis is followed by mitosis. Thus, the 4 cells will become 8 cells. So the 8 ascospores will be produced within the sac-like structure, which is called ascus. Coming to the next sexual spores, that is basidiospores. Basidiospores are 4 haploid single-celled spores which are produced on the structure which is known as basidium. Basidium are club-shaped structure that is formed by the fusion of gametangia of 2 mating types. In this case also, the nuclear fusion takes place inside the basidium, which is followed by meiosis, and thus 4 haploid nuclei are produced. In the case of ascospores, These haploid nuclei were forming spores endogenously within the sac-like structure, which is called ascus. But in the case of basidiospores, they are produced exogenously outside the basidium at the tip of special outgrowths, which are called sterigma. Thus, four basidiospores can be seen, each on one sterigma that is protruding out from the basidium. Sometimes, as in the case of ascospores, this meiosis may be followed by a mitosis, and in such cases, eight spores can be also seen. Examples of fungus which produce basidiospores include the mushrooms, puffballs, bracket fungi, which include the inedible mushrooms. Coming to zygospores, zygospores are large thick-walled rusting spores that are formed by the fusion of tips of two sexually compatible hyphae. In this case, the zygospores remain as diploid structures after the nuclear fusion of haploid cells. In the case of fungi, during the sexual spore formation only, they remain in the diploid nature. These zygospores are rusting spores and they will remain dormant in adverse environmental conditions. And when the environmental conditions are favorable, the zygospore will germinate and it will undergo meiosis and the haploid vegetative cells are released. Examples of fungus which produce zygospores include rhizopus and mucor. Coming to the last sexual spores, that is oospores. Oospores are formed by gametangial population. In this case, the female gametangia is called oogonium and it will be containing well-differentiated sex cells or the female gametes called oospheres. In one oogonium, oogonium is a large ball-like structure. Within one oogonium, one or more oospheres can be seen. Here, the male structure is not differentiated into gametes and the male structure will come in contact with the oogonium. The fertilization will take place when the male nucleus migrate through the fertilization tube or fertilization pore into the female oogonium. The oospheres will get fertilized and it will give rise to the sexual spores known as oospores. Example is saprolechnia. Asexual and sexual spores of fungus are not always open structures. They may be surrounded or enclosed within highly organized protective structures called fruiting bodies. Sexual fruiting bodies are known as pedicetium and apothecium, and asexual fruiting bodies are called acervulus and pycnidium. That's all about sexual reproduction in fungus. Thank you.